Yes! It's finally over! Ladies and gentlemen, it finally happened. That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the channel. Look, the official PlayStation branding of It's Only on PlayStation has officially been bubbled. That's going to be the best way to put it. Thank you, Gundam. You see, what happened now is that Ghost of Tsushima, that's going to be a mouthful for me. I mean, wouldn't be the first time. Is finally going to be hitting the PC, which marks it as the last game on their entire branding, the entire PS4 life cycle, about
It's Only on PlayStation.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, now it has been proven fact, you don't need a PlayStation for PlayStation games anymore. I think the only one left is Bloodborne, from my understanding. Imagine sitting there and defending a console in plastic box talking about exclusives when you're literally losing every exclusive possible. The more hilarious part about all of this was not 2 weeks ago how PlayStation fanboys were lamenting, screaming, and coming for joy about Xbox going third party when PlayStation has in fact itself been third party for quite some time. You don't need an Xbox to play games anymore, they would cry. Well, I don't need a PS5 or a PS4 anymore to play PlayStation games. Especially with the way Hiroki Totoki was talking about getting games out faster on PC. So, your margins. So what happened this time, Alex? Do we have a bunch of tweets of people getting angry at a company and corporation for wanting to make money? Yes, we do. We also have other things happening as well. You see, because Twitter is only the tip of the iceberg, this has officially bled over not only into the PlayStation blog post, but also on the Steam itself. So with all that being said, everyone, sit down, strap in, buckle up, get that plug in there, cause the salt is coming, and so am I. Sucker Punch tweets out, Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut comes to PC May 16th. We are thrilled to collaborate with Nixxis Software and can't wait for PC players to experience Jin's Journey, the Iki Island expansion, and Legends Co-op multiplayer. Learn more at PlayStation Blog. Link below. Ah, you know, there's probably nothing wrong with this tweet. There's not going to be anything insane happening on below it, right? There's no one going to be sitting here and saying horrible things or just really just screaming at a company that wants to make money, is there? Oh, no, let's go ahead and see what we got here. Cappy on the Move says, "Stop porting our exclusives to PC, you fucking cunts!" And then SJ right below it saying, "Worst thing is a lot," that's not how you spell a lot, by the way, "of PC players pirate games." You know what, I love the fact that this is a double whammy inside of one tweet, because not only are they back to back responding to each other about this, one we have having an actual meltdown, which is old Cappy on the Move, and the other one, who can't even spell correctly, is not talking about PC players pirating games, which is, well, funny enough, because Ghost of Tsushima is listed as some of the top selling games on Steam right now. Baby, we're looking pretty. It looks like on this side, we buy our games, because apparently you guys don't, because your margins aren't good enough, and you'll buy enough games to warrant you guys keeping those games. So, you might as well join the Xbox, brethren, my boys. Start putting your games everywhere. Andres Gutierrez says, "Fuck them PC cucks." Ah, one of the classics back at it again. My boy, every single time a PC port is announced, you are screaming, crying, shitting, and cumming your pants at the top of your lungs about PC cuckery and all this bullshit, when you're the exact same person who was cucking for Sony while never having a PlayStation 5 console. Literally just posting things about playing Xbox, which is the funniest thing about all of this. You're also the same person who's cucking for Sony so hard that you're so excited about Xbox leaving the hardware business, when you don't realize Sony's gonna do that too. In fact, they're probably gonna be pushing it faster than you think, because if you were actually buying PlayStation games, they wouldn't be making them multi-plat, now would they? Because in reality, there's no need for a PS5 anymore, because Ragnarok, all the other games, Final Fantasy VII, the new one, that's all gonna come to PC too. Every time, my boy. Every single time. Honest Guy Who's Never Lied says, PC players celebrating getting a 4-year-old port for $60. Crying emoji times two, laughing emoji one time. You see, my boy who never lies, apparently you can't even do math either, because you had to pay $29.99 if you only had the standard version of Ghost of Tsushima on your PS4. That is an $89.99 game if you wanted to get the full experience. If you already had the director's cut, you then had to pay an additional $10 to get all of that content, making your total cost of that game to be $70. On the PC side, however, we're getting all of the content, all of the features, all new settings, all new modes, all new options, and a better playing experience while only paying $60. You got cucked, my boy! Imagine PlayStation treating PC players better than your actual customers who are crying and screaming about exclusives matter! Only Sony, baby! We're the only ones! Exclusives! Exclusives! But yet when it doesn't become an exclusive, you're the ones paying out the nose and get treated like dirt the most. Am I lying? Yeri Bakan Abedin says, PC owners don't deserve this. It would be better if they never had access to PlayStation games. Please cancel it. Please, PlayStation! Please! These guys don't deserve it! You shouldn't take their money! Oh my god, no! Cancel it! I can't use it in my stupid Twitter wars about video games! The fact that 92 other people behind you tweeted and were like, yes, let me like this post, truly goes to show this content train is never going to actually end. It is a continuation of just giant man-children screaming and crying, creating list wars and just infographics about how many exclusives somebody has when in reality, you don't have any exclusives anymore. They're all gone. At the most, it'll be 6 months that you'll have it. And then surprise, you're third party, baby. It's over. It's almost like if you would have bought your games in the first place, this wouldn't be happening. But instead of you guys actually playing video games and buying video games, you're too busy hanging out on Twitter, jacking each other off like a bunch of clowns about video game console wars. Looks like I win again. Every time. Brams Sinista says, I see, while he goes ahead and lists the only on PlayStation banner. 203 likes. Brams, let me go ahead and fix that for you, okay? Next time, I want you to go ahead and tweet this one out instead. See, this is the new official PlayStation logo marketing for you guys of only on PlayStation. The fact that you guys bought this hook, line, and sinker, this marketing, this playbook, is really the funniest thing about all this, because you're nothing more than a bunch of fucking marks. You've always been marks, you'll always be marks, and you're nothing more than a wallet to prolapse because you identify yourself as a PlayStation gamer rather than just a person who enjoys video games. Denying yourself all the other great parts of life because I don't wanna play on PlayStation, I don't wanna play it anywhere else. And then your friends behind you are going, yeah, bro, we get it. Come on, man, we gotta stop these guys from playing video games, even though they're just really just additional customers that PlayStation could profit off of, because exclusivity is honestly just a bullshit term and it shouldn't be there in the first place. That's really what it is. What's funny about all of this, though, is most of you guys were really hating on Xbox games, but the second those Xbox games are no longer exclusive, now you love Xbox games. Ladies and gentlemen, we're not done there, because the fanboys have apparently found out what Steam is and have decided to actually infiltrate Steam itself directly. Here are some actual forum posts on the Ghost of Tsushima store page, and it's great. Let's go ahead and have some fun though, shall we? I'm actually on the real Steam forum page. Our friend Soul here says, why is it on PC? Please continue to support PlayStation and buy a PS5 plus this game on PlayStation. I don't know why Sony starts porting all the games to PC. ! Yeah, about 8 times out. Simple. Money. Thanks, Tarzan. You really hit the nail on the head. But let's have some fun, shall we? Let's go to Soul's profile page and let's see what we got, my boy. Oh. 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 Oh! Oh, yes! 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 Every time, every single time, but it doesn't stop there. Let's go again. Spooky Skeleton says, why, Sony, why? Why are you allowing PC snobs to play our games? This was one of the last games we had to ourselves, and you're just handing it to them. They do not deserve this masterpiece. I was a loyal customer for many, many years, but this is the last straw. I think I'll be switching to Xbox next year just in spite of you. Until then, at least we'll have Bloodborne. Devil face emoji. Zero games owned! Zero DLC owned! 35 reviews. How does that even happen? What are we talking about here? What do you mean zero games owned? What is this? What are we looking at here? Something is wrong while trying to display this content. What did you last play? What did you last play? Do you even have that on here? I can find out. Let's go ahead and see. For some reason, I can't pull up any of the games he apparently has played, even though he has an achievement showcase. But look at this comment right here. Put this on the profile of people who are known wanted terrorists that were involved in September. Bro. What? Yo, Steam is a wild place, my boys. Let's keep going. Let's head to a good one, shall we? This topic has actually been locked by the moderators. Fox says, don't buy this. Sony is playing with us real fans who bought the game back in 2020. It is a betrayal. We feel stabbed in the back. Don't support this. Don't buy. Let them take a loss and regret the decision. PS5 will always be the definitive platform to play Ghost of Tsushima. Wow, we got the jester emote for 247 times. The hilarious emote for 29, 4 awards, and a couple of saucies. Let's check the profile, baby. What do we got? PS5, Bernardus, 1911. Let's go ahead and see what we got here, baby. Here's your actual PlayStation profile. Let's scroll down because you linked it. You're not even playing Spider-Man. You're not playing Need for Speed. You didn't fucking play Ghost of Tsushima 1. You didn't play Resistance. You didn't play FF7 Remake. You didn't play Neo, The World Ends With You. You didn't even play Foam Stars. You didn't play Yakuza. You didn't play Outer Worlds or Evil West or Replicant. Why do you have a PlayStation 5 and you're angry about these games going to PC when you don't even play Ghost of Tsushima? You have 7 copper trophies. 7 copper trophies. Exposed! Ladies and gentlemen, exposed! You have 969 games here on Steam. You played Half-Life Alyx. You have a VR headset. And you're sitting here crying? Getting an entire thread locked? And linking your PlayStation account with no trophies? The Cloud Show is in full session, ladies and gentlemen! It never ends! We even have people on Steam buying games, being PC gamers, and not even able to actually play the games they even have on their own, which they're trying to fight for not being on the PC platform when they have a PC and they play PC games. But you see, we're not done yet because, in fact, the PlayStation blog for Ghost of Tsushima Director's Cut on PC is here. And let's take a look at the comments. Pro gamer, bunch of numbers, boo! Yeah, okay, buddy. Somebody's really angry about all of this. Underdrill saying, hey, thanks for porting this game to PC. Looking forward to playing it for the first time with a DualSense controller, 120 frames per second. Awesome. Super Saiyan 2023 says, yeah, and then Sony is curious why they don't reach their PS5 console sales goal, LOL. Thankfully, with key stores, I could rebuy my PS library on Steam very cheap. So I'm ready to abandon this platform similar to how Sony is abandoning it. Nintendo plus PC is the way nowadays. Nobody tell them what you can do with a PC and Nintendo games. Okay? Nobody tell them. Nobody let them know. Nobody give them anything. Don't tell them. Don't say nothing to them. And the funniest thing about this Super Saiyan is you're going off again and rebuying all of the games you already have because somebody else gets to play your video game that you liked on your platform on a different platform. So you're going to spend double the money, even though it's cheaper. You probably bought all these games day one, too, so you're one of those suckers. Then you're going to go to actual key sites to rebuy those same games again. Because somebody else gets to play the... Bro, a sucker is born every 30 seconds, ladies and gentlemen. Every time, even on their own blog, it doesn't get better than this. Truth Exposed 4. God, these fucking names every time. Trash. Nixus worst PS dev. Only on PlayStation Heritage ruined for pennies. How you've fallen, Sony. They haven't fallen. They're making money. They know where the money is. They know that selling the game to more people makes more money for themselves. And that's what they're going to do. Surprise. Welcome to Economics 101. If I can sell it to more people, more people are going to buy it. Who would have fucking knew, you clown? You should have gotten mad the second they bought Nixus, but you weren't angry then. But now you're angry? What did you think Nixus did? Hello? Oh my fucking god. Omega Zeo, this guy is a psychopath. Watch this. PlayStation gamers, are you going to keep allowing this piece of shit company to keep playing us, PC is killing the PlayStation community identity platform. Do y'all not see what happened? Xbox, not only PC destroyed it, y'all are doing the same. If this gets removed, I take it as a declaration of war, and there will be repercussions. If you're a real PlayStation fan, speak up. What is PC doing for us PlayStation gamers? Nothing. If y'all think PC is going to benefit us, I got the Declaration of Independence to sell you. We PlayStation gamers are not your toys. Without us, you are nothing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, Eris.
Why are we still here? Just to suffer.
You speak facts and the truth, fellow Sony fan.
A declaration of war! I fucking cannot, dude. This dude is a psychopath.
If you ever have the misfortune of seeing this guy on Twitter, it is an absolute nightmare. This is the same person that was trying to send specific messages of a discerning decree that would have people delete their save files if they weren't stopping putting games on the PC. Yeah, he was literally tagging the CEOs and people of Sony, saying that he was going to do things to the actual headquarters if they didn't stop doing this. It's amazing. It's amazing that we found him here today. What a psycho. Let's go, baby. Traitors! PlayStation has become irrelevant! Yes! Yes! Oh! I finally hit it! You made me finish! What a mess! Oh, just everywhere. It's just a mess. It's just a load. Oh, call your dad to come clean it up with his tongue. I must be quenched. My thirst, I'm parched immensely. Amazing. Amazing. Traitors! And then E with a bunch of numbers. Why should I buy future games on PS5 and future PlayStation consoles when games get ported to PC? I can wait. They will all get ported anyways. It's AE. The fact that you're paying for PS Plus pretty much means you're a simp. You've definitely given so much money to this company, more than you can honestly imagine. And there's no shot in hell you're going to go ahead and buy a PC to play PlayStation games and wait when your friends on that same service that you pay for extra money, for getting nothing in return, are all playing those games as well. You're not gonna wait, my boy, because if you would have waited, you actually wouldn't be on here in the first place making these kinds of comments, being this much of a fucking simp for a corporation every single time, my boy. You are nothing more than a wallet to Prolapse and Goatsy every single time. You're going to get played that way. Because when the next PlayStation comes out, you're going to be there day one to buy it. When the next trailer comes out, you're going to be there day one to like it. When the next game comes out, you're going to be there saying, look at this exclusive that nobody else has. And 6 months later, why are you taking away my exclusive? That's you, my boy. Hook, line, and sinker. But you see, Andrew Squaw came back at it with another one, saying, I've been ranting and raving about this since 2021 and was told to be quiet plenty of times on here. Glad to see you're all starting to realize the problem. It was in 2021 that no new confirmed PS5 only first party games were on the way and still aren't 3 years later. It's like you guys went ahead and decided to defend a company that doesn't give you the products that you want, and you're here trying to defend them still to this very day. Because I know the second, the moment, the instance that a 30 second trailer comes out or a 3 minute trailer, you're gonna be back gawking 9,000 on that Jim Ryan dickety dick faster than Belladonna on a bender, my boy. That's how it's gonna be. That's how it's always been. And again, there you have it. Another batch of PlayStation fanboys getting angry that somebody else gets to play a video game that didn't have to buy their $500 precious box. Look, here's the thing. You shouldn't have to spend extra money to buy a box to play the video game on when that game can be played on everything else. It really is nothing more than a cult of personality, and you're falling for it every single time. To sit there and defend a company and corporation to try and tell them to not make more money by selling the game to other people truly is the most possibly imagine. The fact that you are sitting here getting angry that a corporation is doing what they can to make more money because you don't want to buy more games is literally your fault entirely. If you'd spend less time on Twitter, less time on Steam forum posts, and less time in actual blog posts and actually playing your video games and buying them, we wouldn't be in the situation now, would we? But instead, no, here we are. Margins are too thin, my boys, and games will be coming day and day to PC and PlayStation, making your console absolutely fucking irrelevant. But you know what? We don't even have to wait because it's already being proven relevant right now. Congrats, boys. You played yourself. And with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for watching today's video. If you liked it, thank you. If you didn't like it, Fuck you. If you want to see more of this kind of content, subscribe to the channel. We are doing more PC port reviews, gaming news, Steam Deck videos, some hot takes that I have, maybe some response videos apparently too. Those are kind of taking off apparently. People like it when I roast somebody. Who knew that would be the thing of this channel? And even then, more live streams on Saturday night at 8:45 p.m. Eastern, where I get berated by my chat through TTS and get called a furry, bald, have a foot fetish, all those wonderful things all at once by everyone. And it's always a great time. But look, if you want to join the Discord and get emotes during those live streams, become a YouTube member. It's as low as a dollar. And if you don't want to spend the dollar, don't sweat it. It's all good. Just come on down to the live stream and have a great time and hang out. You'll like it. Trust me. Chat runs the show here. That's how things go. But with that being said, y'all, I want to say thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you have a great one. And I'll see you next time.
Stop. Just stop.